today, our PR agency, Kyra & Co., along with my colleagues, Griselda, Shannon, and Natalie, will be presenting you our campaign plan that best fits L'Oreal's brief. So the challenge we were faced with in the brief was how to engage both beauty professionals and consumers with our campaign. So we came up with the name Love Real Hair. We came up with the campaign name Love Real Hair because one day I was sitting down to lunch with a friend of mine and she was telling me she was looking for a shampoo for her hair. She has kinky hair and she couldn't find shampoo for her hair. So later when I was sitting down discussing with my colleagues, we thought this would be a great idea to base our campaign on. And we decided to use the following products, and specifically Mizani, because as you can see in this slide, Mizani is there for women with all different hair types. So we want to get the message across that L'Oreal is there for you, no matter what your hair type is. So our campaign strategies and goals. So our campaign will be through the 12th and 30th of May, because the holy month of Ramadan is set to begin June 6th, so we don't want to interfere in our consumers' private lives. So we want our consumers to be fully focused on our campaign when we can get them to focus on it. And we'll also donate the funds from our Born with L'Oreal event to raise funds for a worthy cause. And this is a key strategy because CSR initiatives are one of the key operational strategy processes in PR. And we're also keeping our stakeholders in mind and letting them know that we care about L'Oreal's reputation and brand. We'll now be using social outbound engagement to send messages to our consumers over social media, because L'Oreal has a very strong presence on Facebook, as we will discuss later on in the campaign. And we want to generate content that will get them thinking about L'Oreal as a brand that is there for them and gives them something more than just products. So we want to focus on their PR initiatives and not just their products. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll now hand over to my colleague, Griselda, who will tell you more about our campaign events.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Griselda Gonsalves. I will be speaking to you about the timeline of our campaign as well as the events that we plan to host for our campaign. So for the timeline, we will be starting our social media campaign on the 25th of April. It's a bit earlier compared to when we plan to actually launch our campaign. This is to drive consumer engagement. On 12th of May, we'll be releasing our press release. On 15th to 17th of May, we will be participating in Beauty World Middle East, which is a beauty exhibition. And on 20th May, we will be hosting a campaign, which is a Fun with L'Oreal campaign. It's a water balloon fight. So the first, that is a social media campaign. This will be done mostly on Facebook and Instagram. It's to engage our consumers, for them to tell us more about how has L'Oreal helped them achieve or make them feel confident about their hair. And they also share their viewpoints, and these cater to both the younger as well as the older demographics. For next, these are how our social media pages look like. The Beauty World Middle East is basically one of the top 5 exhibitions that's held in Dubai for beauty products. Now, this is an industry-specific event, so over here we're trying to cater just to our beauty professionals. And through this event, we plan to launch our campaign right over here. That's running from the 15th to 17th of May, as I mentioned before. And this is a brochure that we have designed to cater to our audience. Followed by our third event, which is Fun with L'Oreal. So in this event, we will be giving our audience, or basically consumers, free coupons to participate in a lucky draw. Those who win through this lucky draw get a chance to participate in the event, which will be held at Zabid Park on a Friday, 20th May, because Friday is a public holiday in Dubai, so it's easier to get people to participate. So basically the participants, they get divided into two teams. The winning team gets a chance to get their hair styled by L'Oreal's professional stylist, that is Chadgun, as well as other beauty professionals. So what we're trying to do in this event is engage both the consumers and the beauty professionals. We also have a flyer designed for it. So what we're trying to do through all these three events is one event which caters only through beauty professionals, one event that caters only to our consumers, and one event that engages both the beauty professionals and the consumers. Now I would like to hand over the presentation to my colleague Shannon.
Good morning, my name is Shannon D'Souza and I will be talking about the press release. We are releasing this press release to inform our audience about all the events that my colleague Griselda talked about, the Beauty World 2016 event, the social media campaign, as well as the Fun with L'Oreal event. The press release will be released on May 12th. We have done extensive research of the different publications present in the United Arab Emirates and compiled our media list, which you can see consists of Gulf News, Khaleej Times, Aquarius, Connector, Friday Magazine, Harper's Bazaar Arabia, to cater to the local audience, and Arabia and Friday Magazine. Test. We have done a political, economic, social, and technological analysis of the United campaign. In the United Arab Emirates, there is a very high level of social responsibility awareness raised, and it also engages our community members and takes into accordance their interests. The UAE's organizations consist of a culture of justice and care for their community, and also UAE's organizational focus is shifted through this campaign from a focus on a profit margin to the social responsibility by taking into consideration the corporate social responsibility policies and strategies. Our economic factors focus on the United Arab Emirates economy, which is currently stagnant due to the drop in oil prices, but still remains strong. As you can see, our global presence of L'Oréal, the brand, is very strong, as it has brands in France, Italy, Japan, and Britain. In the MENA region, which is the Middle East and North Africa, there's a 12.1 increase in growth rate, which is the largest in the entire region since December 2017, as well as L'Oréal stands first in hair color and only second in hair care to Procter & Gamble. Now I will hand over to my colleague, Natalie.
Good morning, my name is Natalie Vortes, and I will be presenting on the social and the technological factors of the pest analysis. So when it comes to the social factors, as you can see, L'Oréal caters to different Afro hair types. And this is a niche market that very few hair product companies export into. The team also consists of culturally diverse hair professionals. I'd like to draw your attention to the fact that Dubai consists of 3.2 million people. And out of these 3.2 million people, 1.3 are women that fall under the demographic of 20 to 39. And this is our target audience because we'll be targeting women specifically. This actually lowers the chance of the loyalty of the generation shifting because of the next generation overtaking them. The technological factors are the fact that 50% of the entire UAE population has social media accounts. Bearing that in mind, I'd like to draw your attention to the statistics of their social media pages, which is the L'Oréal Middle East specifically. The L'Oréal Middle East page has 557,000 followers, but this actually, their separate product pages such as Keratin and Redken supersede the amount of their main brand page. This is seen as well in their other social media pages such as Instagram and Twitter. I would like to conclude this presentation with the fact that our success of the campaign will be evaluated based on certain factors such as the sale of L'Oréal products, increase in awareness of the campaign and its CSR efforts. Attendance at the campaign events will also be considered, and based on the assumption solely that the campaign success will be measured based on the number of likes and followers that the page gets. With this campaign plan, we hope to engage both consumers and beauty professionals.
Okay, there are no questions then. Thank you, ladies. And could everybody finish up the assessment sheet, please?
Thank you. let me turn this off.